Hi, it's Carol from Allergy Free Living, and today we're going to do a recipe called meatloaf with cheese and cooked in muffin tins. And this is a really quick way to make meatloaf in 22 to 28 minutes versus almost an hour. So we're going to start out with a meatloaf mix. And then we have beaten eggs, and everything that I have in here, I always put the amount on the website or the video. So here's your eggs, almond milk, onions, breadcrumbs, gluten-free, and then we have uncooked oatmeal, and that's gluten-free oatmeal. It's a Bob Red Mill, which is on the video for a must-have pantry, which if you haven't seen it, you really should. And the next is rice. And the special ingredients, one of them is maple syrup. And the next real good ingredients is the ketchup. Not everybody has that in their recipe, but they really add a really good flavor to it. And let's just mix this. Now, with this recipe, there's a lot of things in it, but when you taste it, it's really good. I know a lot of times people think that, you know, meatloaf is just blah. This is not blah at all. And make sure that you really do a good job mixing it. Now, you prepare your muffin tins. You know, there's quite a bit here, so I'm not going to put it all in the muffin tin. I'm just showing you it in a six. This is the muffin tin, because, you know, it takes a lot of time to do it, so I'm just going to show you in the 6-cup muffin tin, which has been prepared with a spray. Okay. Now, I'm going to have to get a special spoon. It's like a cutting board. And the first thing you're going to do is, this is a big scooper. It's for cookies. But this is what you're going to do. You're going to get a good scoop like this. And you're going to get 6 good scoops. You see how they're definitely over. And I'm putting them on this for a reason, and you'll see. Everybody's muffin tins should be about the same, but if they aren't, then you don't need as big a scoop as I have. But these are not the large ones. These are just regular muffin tins. Now, obviously, I still have some of the meatloaf mixture left, but I'm not using it all because It doesn't, I don't need to use it and show, waste that time. Now, I'm just going to take these and make them so that they're round. Roll them around your hands. You might need water. Mine are moist enough so that they don't need it. Now, there's a couple of surprises that are going to go into my muffin meatloafs. And one will be a cube of cheese. And it's the Cabot Vermont cheddar. So I take it and just push it right in there. And move it on the top so that you don't see it and go like this. And you wouldn't know that there's the cheese inside there. So I put it right in this muffin tin. And I'm going to do the same thing to all the other ones. Just pop the cheese square in there. Move the meatloaf around. Roll it around in my hands, and again, put it in the tin and just kind of press it. And I'm going to do that for all of them. The cheese, pop it right there in the middle, move it around. And you see, this is going pretty fast. Kind of like a humongous meatball. Now that might be a good thing to make for meatballs, actually, a surprise. But you know, I'm not sure how that would work. I guess we could try it, couldn't we? Because if you're gonna put it in the sauce, even if it opened, the cheese would come pouring out. So that does kind of sound good. Okay, now, here it is. All right, this is what they look like. Now, I'm just going to get them so I press them down a little. And I have a special sauce that I put on these. Now, when I do the recipe on the website, you'll see it. But it has ketchup, it has honey, brown sugar, and mustard. So, what I'm going to do is just take a little spoon of it and put it on the top, just on the top. And as you're doing it, just kind of press it down. Okay. Now, I have 6 pieces of bacon cooked, okay? And I'm putting them right on top that, on top of the dollop of the special sauce. See, just putting it right on top there. Already cooked bacon. All right, there we go. Now, if that isn't enough, there you go. And if you see, there is a little space that I leave around the circle of the muffin tin. And that's because I'm going to just take it and put another dollop on this. I guarantee you that if your little ones see this, they're definitely going to eat that meatloaf, because that to them will look real good. So that's what this looks like. So I'll put it in the oven, and it takes anywhere from 22 to 28 minutes depending on your oven. So that's, but it should register with your thermometer 160. Now when you're putting your thermometer in here, try not to get it right in the middle where the cheese is, because then you're going to be, you know, seeing what the temperature of the cheese is. You should maybe take it a little bit more to the side where the cheese wasn't, and make sure it registers to 160. So these are what they look like when they're not cooked. And of course, as you know, I already have them done. So this is what they look like done. Now, I did leave a space because I have a little hint to give all of you about if you're cooking things in muffin tins, and maybe if you don't have a big 12 muffin tin holder, maybe you have just the 6 ones, and let's say one of them you only get 5, like I have. Before you cook, put this in the oven, you fill the empty muffin tin about a little below half. And then that way, it evenly cooks this whole muffin tin. But if you don't put the water in, sometimes what's next to it on either side, they don't cook as evenly. So that's just a hint. So let's take one. This is one of them that's done. And I just wanna cut it in half. And let's see what it looks like. There you go. You see the little hole of cheese? So that's the surprise for the little kids. And I'm sure when they see that, they'll really like it. Okay, that's it for today. And I hope you enjoyed it. And remember, if you haven't seen my pantry video, then you really should, because if you have all the stuff needed in a pantry, you'll be able to make all these things without a problem and having to take a trip to the store. So go and see that video if you haven't, and I hope you enjoyed this.